Hello everyone, hope you're doing well in these crazy times. Welcome back to a new helicopter update video. This time is version 0.9, so we're getting closer to the, let's say, final release 1.0, which should be the best one of them all, of course, but I'm sure they're not gonna stop there because there's really loads of work to do. And let's not waste any more time and let me show you right away what they changed in this build. Okay, here we are inside the cockpit. We can see that everything is pretty much how it used to be, except for a few details. Here, for example, in this panel, many lights have been added, for example, engine fire and emergency notifications, and the torque control with the pedals has been regulated a bit, tweaked for easier takeoff. And let's fire it up. Okay, control 5, we can now see here we have the EPU switch right here. So I'm gonna press it and then with control 4 I can get to the overhead panel. Can make a lamp test. Actually, let's see if the lamp test works. It does. Perfect. So we can see all the lights. It got off. Here we have loads of messages improved as well. EPU switch is here if you want. Of course, if you switch off the only power source, everything shuts down. Good job. Anyway, let's turn on the battery. We can see this is noticeably different from the previous build. Avionics master are on, pitot heat, I can put everything on already. Here everything on, then we put strobe. This I don't know what it is. Position, it's okay. These are cabin lights, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead and start our engines at the same time, of course. So we have the searchlight, which was called previously spotlight, I believe it is that one. Few things have been changed. You cannot find anymore the parking brake here. You can activate lights from here. And then, as usual, the configuration screen. Engines are running. To idle, remember to scroll here instead of clicking. These knobs, they look now I don't remember, but they look better than the last time. It's been a few days and my memory is really bad. Okay, let's set everything to flight. Okay, perfect. It switched from battery to generators. And I should turn off the EPU, no? So, control 5. No EPU. Okay, you cannot do it. Perfect. But we have our co-pilot back. You just click on the seatbelt and there she is. She's not there anymore. Very easy. Okay, let's bring it up in the air. We are currently on an aircraft carrier. Because why not? And yeah, I'll tell you more about it in the air. Okay, let's see how's the takeoff now. Slowly increase power. I'm gonna start to counteract the force. Okay, More or less. Okay, let's see around here what's interesting here. Okay, this ship, I could land on it. Yeah, looks doable. There's a submarine there as well. Of course, guys, I will leave, as usual, link down in the description below for this helicopter to download it and try it out yourself. And as well for the aircraft carrier mod, which is quite interesting. I made a video on that as well. If you want to check it out, you can find it on the upper right corner right now, more or less. And yeah, let's have a look around. That's an helipad. Perfect. I can land there as well. So right now there's a bit of wind, 12 knots to be exact, and it's gonna make things a little bit more interesting. Right, but you're watching this video to know what's been changed. So, besides what I told you already, the pilot model, which means your pilot, is available. I'll show you. If you click on your seatbelt, the pilot will show up. Right now the helicopter is uncontrolled, very good. Now ECAS messages light up when appearing and the ACK button dismisses them. They added a rear overhead view, Gen 1, Gen 2 and EPU, as we saw before. Fuel prime pumps to be used only during startup. We are a bit too close to the water here. And the flight model had some changes as well. They boosted ETL and the ground effect is now relative to the density altitude. They updated normal procedures on the EFB. The parking brake has been removed from the config page. Change beacon to ACOL light, nav to position light, and you can also remove middle row seat of the on the table config page. So let's see, config. Wait a second. Middle seat. We can remove them and let's see how it looks. Yeah. So it's now cargo helicopter. You can actually fly it from the inside. Like this. Wow, cool. Okay. Let's go back to an appropriate view. What else? Minor changes like fixing carpet map overlap on captain's side, first officer cyclic stand bracket being missing. They fixed it. And they removed the taxi light, which was not realistic. They removed unused button on the main MFDs. And emergency light switch added. And as well, ready for takeoff config will now set you up with the current barometric pressure, the local one, so you are good to go. You press that one and you don't have to set anything else. They made some changes as well for the pilot view position for VR, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Was a big up, sort of a big update, much more than last time, but nothing crazy still. Anyway, enough talking and let's try to land this bad boy on this ship. So let's reduce collective. Right now I'm in advanced model, so I'm practicing. Where am I? Can't see. I think I overran it. I don't see, so I'm gonna give a bit of power. No, I'm actually on it. And okay, let's see how it looks. Meh. A bit too close to this pole, but I guess it will work. Yeah, why not? Oh, this livery, by the way, I said already in another video, but I will leave the link down in the description as well for this, and it's an add-on, free. It doesn't come with the helicopter, so if you want it and you like it, you have to download it yourself. Anyway, guys, this is it for this video. Once again, this helicopter is getting improved steadily, constant pace. Really, really nice model. And let's see what comes up next. And as usual, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like if you didn't, a dislike, and I'll see you in the next one.